Completing the TIF Annual Reporting Form, Part 13, the Annual Disclosure Statement and Comments tabs. Per the TIF Act, a development authority must publish an annual statement disclosing information regarding the TIF districts located within the municipality no later than August 15th in the newspaper of general circulation. All TIF districts that are required to report to the Office of the State Auditor must be included in the annual disclosure statement. Publication of the annual disclosure statement is required, even if the amounts are zero. The authority must provide a copy of the annual disclosure statement to the OSA, the county auditor, the county board, and the governing body of the municipality, if different from the authority, by August 1st each year. This tab is used to facilitate this requirement. It is not necessary to submit an affidavit of publication to the OSA. Most of the information on the ADS tab is populated from other tabs. Lines 1 and 2 show the name of the development authority and the municipality. On line 3, enter the name of the newspaper in which the ADS was or will be published and enter the date of publication. The net tax capacity data on lines 4 through 6 are populated from lines 4 through 6 of the District Information tab. Line 7 shows the principal and interest payments due in the following reporting year and is populated from the total amounts of principal and interest due in the following year on the debt, interfund loans, and PAYGO tabs. Lines 8 and 9 show the tax increment received and expended in the current reporting year. These lines are populated with information from the Revenues and Expenditures tab. See our written instructions for more information. Line 10 shows the month and year of first tax increment receipt from line 12 of the Overview tab. Line 11 shows the date of required decertification from line 13 on the Overview tab. Line 12 is populated with the total increased property taxes to be paid from outside the district if fiscal disparities option A applies as populated from line 10 of the District Information tab. Lines 4 through 11 must be published even if the amounts are zero. Line 12 is only necessary if the municipality is located in a fiscal disparity area and the municipality chose option A under Minnesota Statute 469-177 Subdivision 3A for the district. Line 12 is labeled with an asterisk and must be accompanied by the corresponding notation when required. The notation explains what the amount on line 12 represents. The annual disclosure statement must also inform readers how they can obtain additional information regarding each district. Enter on lines 13 through 19 the contact person and their address, phone, and email. If you have any comments, explanations, changes, or requests, please enter them in the Comments tab. If you have any questions about the Annual Disclosure Statement tab or Comment tab, please contact the TIF Division.